children at home. My name is Elia. Welcome to BGCSE Biology. Today we are looking at levels of organization. So you find that if you look at living things, they are made of an array of different levels of organizations that can be arranged into a hierarchy. So if you look here, the first level of organization is an organelle. So when we're talking about an organelle, we are talking about the internal parts of a cell. For example, we know that if you look at your animal cell or your plant cell, inside you have your mitochondria, your nucleus, your cytoplasm. So those things, they fall under a level called the organelles. And then moving on, the next level will be a cell. A cell is a basic unit of life, and then we know that we have our animal cells and then we have our plant cells. And then moving to the next level, we have a tissue. A tissue is a group of cells with a common goal. So if you look at animals, we have animal tissues. For example, we have the connective tissue, we have the epithelium tissue. And then if you go to plant tissues, we have the palisade tissue, we have the spongy tissue, and then we have the parenchyma tissue. These are plant tissues. And then moving to the next level, now this will be the organs. So when we are talking about an organ, we are talking about a group of tissues organized into a functional unit. And then if you look at your animals, we have the heart as an example of the organs. We have the eye as another example. And then if you go to your plants, your organs will be the leaves, and then we have the roots. These are the plant organs, and then these are the animal organs. And then moving to the next level, we have the system now. When you're talking about a system, we are talking about a group of organs with interrelated functions now coming together and then work as one unit. And then if you look at animals, we have the digestive system, which is going to be made of different organs which are involved in digestion. And then we also have the endocrine system. We are going to have those organs which are responsible for the formation of hormones working together. And then if you look at plants, we have the water transport system, the one that is responsible for the movement of water in a plant. So like I said, we are going to have a number of organs working together to transport this water. That's why we are saying it is a water transport system. And then the last and the highest level is the one of an organism. When you're talking about an organism, we are talking about a complete individual with distinctive characteristics. And then, for example, if you look at animals, a human being is an example of an organism, because if you look at a human being, we are talking about a whole independent unit that makes an individual. And then if you go to plants, your organism, you can give an example of a tree. For example, if you look at trees, trees are distinctive individuals. We can also talk about grasses. That's all I had for you on levels of organization.